But first, the weather system, which is already causing havoc in northern New South Wales, is now bearing down on Sydney, and it's packing a punch.
A severe warning has been issued, and we have every angle of this story covered. We'll check in with Tim Bailey and the SES shortly. But we're starting with Gabrielle Boyle in the city, where people are trying to get home before the worst hits. Gabby, how worried should we be?
Look, it's already proving a pretty miserable commute home for thousands of Sydney workers here in the CBD. Whether you're catching the bus, the train, taking your car or even walking, everybody is pretty much armed with an umbrella. Take a look at the weather map and you can see exactly why. We've got a big puddle covering right across the major Sydney basin. Throughout tonight, throughout the evening and into tomorrow morning, we can expect 20 to 40 millimetres of rain in the Sydney Basin. Some areas can expect 60 millimetres, and there is the possibility in some areas of up to 80 millimetres. That is quite a drenching. We know that most of this rain is coming from up north where they're experiencing those flood conditions, so it is heading down towards us here in Sydney, set to get worse. We also know there is a low pressure system out over the east coast, over the ocean, which is bringing pretty dangerous surf conditions. So it really is going to be a night tucked up under the doona, listening to the sound of the rain on your roof.
Gabrielle Ball with the latest. Thank you.
Now for an update on the flooding up north, let's talk to the SES Commissioner Murray Keir. Commissioner, the situation obviously worse. How many people have been evacuated?
Yeah, good afternoon, Bill. We have about 2,400 people now subject to evacuation orders in an area around Moree, including the northern part of the Moree township itself. The good news is many have taken our advice and have left early, gone to friends' places and relatives' places, those sort of things. But a lot of people registering at evacuation centres, as well as other small townships around the Moree area.
Murray Keir from SES headquarters, thank you for your time.
To the latest from the Bureau, and Tim Bailey's with us now. Tim, you know best, when will this wet stuff move on?
Well, as we've just heard, we've got 12 hours of intensive rain. What's happening is the system, although weakening, the cloud's starting to break up and it will move offshore sometime on Friday afternoon. And that will see the rainfall dissipate and also blue skies make a return and a welcome one at that Saturday and Sunday. So we will have lightning and brightening conditions across Saturday and Sunday, temperatures 28 to 30 degrees. Now, right now is the period of the calm before the storm. I'll put it. It looks like the heavy rain will be between midnight and dawn tomorrow morning, and it looks like we'll get, as Gab said, 40 to 60 millimetres looks likely. As we go to air tonight, flash flooding warnings for 14 rivers between Coffs Harbour and the northern border of New South Wales, and of course a severe weather warning in place today and right now for the Illawarra, the Hunter, northwest slopes and plains and the Sydney metropolitan area. Batten down the hatches, here it comes.
Tim Bailey with the latest, that breaking news on Sydney's weather deluge.